Finally, one more thought. Think the printing press, the steam engine, electricity, computing, and the internet. That's what J.P. Morgan's Jamie Dimon compared artificial intelligence to in his shareholder letter this week. And our own Wall Street Week contributor Larry Summers has gone even farther.
This could be the most important general purpose technology since the wheel or fire.
There's no question but that the AI transformation is big and getting bigger and doing it fast as computing power increases geometrically and machines take over some of the thinking for us humans.
It's going to be widely available to hundreds of millions of people. That's going to make us much, much more efficient and productive and much more creative. I think that's going to produce unprecedented value in the next decade.
In fact, we're starting to wonder whether a good number of us may be out of our jobs altogether.
Where is this going to have its immediate impact? It's going to be in the knowledge economy.
We've seen versions of this before, as automation over the years has eliminated entire categories of jobs.
We had 450,000 telephone operators in this country in the 1950s. You tell me the last time you talked to a telephone operator. We had close to 2 million people, I assume most of them women, classified as typists. That's not even a job category anymore in the BLS.
I saw it in my law firm back in the late 1970s. When I went to work as a summer associate at Wilmer Cutler & Pickering in the summer of 1976, I was introduced to the wonders of the steno pool. The firm kept a team of typists, and yes, as I recall, they were all women. On duty, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That meant we lawyers could call in and dictate memoranda and draft briefs at any time of day or night to have them magically appear on our desks before we got in the next morning. And then the word processor came along a few years later and the steno pool simply disappeared. Now, after the pandemic taught us all how to Zoom all the time, the office building that used to hold the steno pool may be disappearing as well, as employers struggle to get their employees back into the office, even for part of the week.
We do believe in flexibility. Mm-hmm. We want people to be able to mix their lives and their work properly.
Steve Cohen has said that the four-day work week, whether from home or from the office, may be next up. But then again, don't be too sure that this will mean less work for us. Those word processors that eliminated our steno pool didn't cut back on the amount of work we lawyers did one bit. To the contrary, it made it possible to do more drafts of those memos with more revisions showing up instantaneously. And instead of dialing into a pool of typists, we did our own typing on computers on our desks and in our homes, in our laps on the road. And don't even get me started on smartphones delivering nonstop emails that people expect us to respond to around the clock, all of which puts that steno pool to shame. But even as technology feels like it lets many of us work harder, word comes out of Germany that there may be relief in sight. No, not for us, but for the machines that were supposed to make our lives easier. It seems that Germany has a hard and fast rule against stores being open on Sundays, dating back 1,700 years when Roman Emperor Constantine the Great first became a Christian and decided everyone should observe that day of rest God took after creating the world, that's according to Genesis. Until now, that's meant that you can't go out and buy pretty much anything on a Sunday in Germany. But 4 years ago, regional supermarket chain Tegut thought it had a way around that ban. It opened some small, fully automated convenience stores staffed by robots. The German union representing service workers took one look at it and cried foul. It took Tegut to court and won in the highest court of the state of Hesse. So much for shopping in Hesse on Sundays. But then again, maybe the service union was getting at something more than giving robots their day of rest. Now that it's won the day off for the next generation of workers, can getting them into the union to agitate for other benefits be far behind? To paraphrase Karl Marx, robots of the world unite.
Murder's a new trick for a robot. Respond.
He don't murder him!
We're gonna miss the good old days.